Welcome to the first of several examples on describing and graphing trig transformations. Here we have y equals negative 3 cosine 6x. So looking at the general form that describes trig transformations, we need to recognize that for this problem, a is equal to negative 3, which is going to affect the amplitude, and b is equal to 6, which will affect the period. So the amplitude is equal to the absolute value of A. So we have the absolute value of negative 3, so the amplitude is equal to 3. But because A was negative, that means it will be a reflection across the midline, or in this case, across the x-axis. And then since B is equal to 6, the period is going to be 2 pi divided by b, so 2 pi divided by 6. The period for this function will be pi over 3 radians. Now let's go ahead and graph the given function based upon what we know about the parent cosine function. And we'll graph this over one period, so what we'll do is start at 0 radians, and we'll go out to pi over 3 radians. And then it's always helpful to divide this interval into 4 equal parts, so we'll divide it in half, and then we'll divide it in half again. So half of pi over 3 would be pi over 6, and half of pi over 6 would be pi over 12. So if we count by 12ths, this is 1 pi over 12, 2 pi over 12, this would be 3 pi over 12. Next, our amplitude is 3, so we'll have a maximum value of 3 and a minimum value of 3. And then from here, we just need to remember the general pattern of the basic cosine function. Meaning if we take a look at one period of the parent cosine function, it starts at a maximum, the next fourth is at the midline, the next fourth is a minimum, the next fourth is the midline, and the next fourth is a maximum. But we do have to be careful about this one because A was negative 3, it's reflected across the midline, or in this case, the x-axis. So instead of starting at a maximum of 3, we're actually going to start at a minimum of negative 3. Again, because A was negative, we're reflecting it across the x-axis. The next fourth will be at the midline. The next fourth, instead of a minimum, will be at a maximum because A is negative 3. The next fourth is at the midline, and the next fourth, again, will be at a minimum of negative 3. Because of the reflection. And now we have all the points we need to make a nice sketch of this graph over the period pi over 3 radians. And there we have the graph. And now that we have one period of the graph, we could extend this to a larger interval if needed. Here are the notes for the transformations of sine and cosine based upon the values of a, b, c, and d. You may want to pause the video if you need to review this.